Hey, my name is Sandeep Tekchandani. I'm the founder of Sandeep.mba and welcome to my GMAT video lesson.
In this video lesson, we will learn quadrilaterals. The focus will be on parallelogram, rectangle, square, and eventually trapezoid. So let's start with parallelogram. A polygon with four sides is a quadrilateral. Quadri means four and lateral means side. For example, JKLM is a polygon with four sides, therefore it's a quadrilateral. A quadrilateral in which both pairs of opposite sides are parallel is a parallelogram. For example, KL is parallel to JM and KJ is parallel to LM. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are also equal in length. For example, KL is equals to JM and KJ is equals to LM. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. For example, the diagonal JL bisects the diagonal KM. Therefore, KN is equals to NM. And JN is equals to NL. The area of a parallelogram is equals to the length of the altitude multiplied by the length of the base. In mathematics, the altitude is the perpendicular drawn from the vertex to the base. Therefore, our altitude is 4 in this case, and the base is 6. Therefore, the area of the parallelogram is equals to 4 times 6, that is 24 square units. In this slide, we will study the rectangle. A parallelogram with right angles is a rectangle. For example, XYZW is a parallelogram. It's a parallelogram because the opposite sides are parallel to each other and they are equal in length. That is, XY is parallel to WZ and XY is equals to WZ. Similarly, XW is parallel to YZ and XW is equals to YZ. So, a parallelogram in which each angle is 90 degrees is a rectangle. And a rectangle with all sides of equal length is a square. The perimeter of WXYZ is equals to twice the length, that is 2 times 3, plus twice the breadth, that is 2 times 7. Therefore, the perimeter of WXYZ is equals to 20 units, and the area of WXYZ is equals to length into breadth, that is 3 times 7 is equals to 21 square units. The diagonals of a rectangle are equal. Therefore, the diagonal WY is equals to the diagonal XZ. Please note that we will use the Pythagoras theorem to find the length of the hypotenuse XZ or WY in this case. In this slide, we'll study the trapezoid. A quadrilateral with two sides that are parallel is a trapezoid. For example, in the figure PQRS, QR is parallel to PS, but QP is not parallel to RS. The area of the trapezoid PQRS may be calculated as follows. My friends, please learn this formula for your exams. The area of a trapezoid is equals to half into sum of the lengths of the bases multiplied by the height. The bases are QR and PS and their sum is 12 plus 16, that is 28, and the height is 8. Therefore, half times 28 times 8 is equals to 112 square units. So let's just summarize, what did we learn in this video lesson? We learned about quadrilaterals. We learned that a quadrilateral in which both pairs of opposite sides are parallel is a parallelogram. The opposite sides of a parallelogram also have equal length. Then we learned that a parallelogram with right angles is a rectangle, and a rectangle with all sides of equal length is a square. Finally, a quadrilateral with two sides that are parallel is called a trapezoid. I hope my video lesson was clear and it will help you to crack all your geometry exams. That is all, my friends.
If you found my video lesson helpful, then you should go to sandeep.mba for more information on the GMAT, how to prepare for the GMAT and applying to business schools. You should also click on that like button and let me know in the comments which topics you would like me to cover in my future video lessons. And of course, if you have not yet subscribed, then go ahead and click on that bell so that you'll get notified about my future video lessons. All the best.